Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we are going to discuss a few results on vector product. We know that vector A cross vector B is equal to A into B into sine of theta into n cap. A is equal to modulus of vector A. B is equal to modulus of vector B. And n cap is a unit vector perpendicular to both vector A and vector B. First we have vector product of two parallel or collinear vectors is zero if the vectors A and B are parallel or collinear. Then the value of theta is equal to 0 or 180 degrees. So in each case, the value of sine of theta will be equal to 0, which implies that vector A cross vector B, which is equal to A into B into sine of angle theta into n cap, will be equal to 0 into n cap, since the value of sine of theta is 0, which is equal to 0 vector. Second result is vector A cross vector A is equal to 0 for any vector A. Therefore, if we have vector A cross vector A, then it is equal to modulus of vector A into modulus of vector A into sine of 0 into n cap, which is equal to 0 into n cap, since sine of 0 is equal to 0. That is equal to 0 vector. Third result is, if vector A cross vector B is equal to 0 vector, then vector A is equal to 0 or vector B is equal to 0 or vector A and vector B are parallel or collinear. Let theta be the angle between vector A and vector B. Then vector A cross vector B is equal to 0 vector implies that A into B into sine of angle theta into n cap is equal to 0 vector, which implies that A into B into sine of angle theta is equal to 0, which implies that A is equal to 0 or B is equal to 0 or sine of angle theta is equal to 0. A is equal to 0 implies that vector A is equal to 0 vector, or B is equal to 0 implies that vector B is equal to 0 vector, or sine of angle theta is equal to 0 implies that theta is equal to 0 or theta is equal to. As sine of theta is equal to 0 for theta is equal to 0 or theta is equal to pi, which implies that vector A is equal to 0 vector, or vector B is equal to 0 vector, or theta is equal to 0 or theta is equal to pi implies that vector A and vector B are collinear or parallel. No. next we are going to discuss vector product of two perpendicular vectors. We know that vector A cross vector B is equal to A into B into sine of angle theta into n cap, when the value of theta is given as pi by 2, then the value of sine of theta, that is sine of pi by 2, is equal to 1. Therefore, vector A cross vector B is equal to A into B into sine of pi by 2, that is 1, into n cap. Or we can say, modulus of vector A cross vector B is equal to modulus of A into B into n cap, which is equal to A into B into modulus of n cap, and modulus of n cap is equal to 1. Therefore, we have A into B. Now we shall discuss vector product of two unit vectors. If A and B are two vectors such that A is equal to modulus of vector A, which is equal to 1, and B is equal to modulus of vector B, which is equal to 1, that is, A and B are unit vectors, therefore, vector A cross vector B, which is equal to A into B into sine of angle theta into n cap, is equal to sine of angle theta into n cap. Since the value of A is equal to 1 and the value of B is also equal to 1, in other words, we can say that the cross product of two unit vectors is a vector whose magnitude is equal to the sine of the angle between the direction of the given vectors. Now we are going to discuss vector product of unit vectors I cap, j cap and k cap. Let I cap, j cap, k cap be the orthonormal triad of the unit vectors. Then I cap cross J cap, which is equal to 1 into 1 into sine of 90 degrees into N cap. Since I cap and J cap are the unit vectors and I cap and J cap are perpendicular to each other, therefore theta is equal to 90 degrees. And n cap is a unit vector perpendicular to both I cap and j cap. And is therefore equal to k cap. Therefore, by definition of orthonormal triad of unit vectors, therefore I cap cross J cap, which is equal to sine of 90 degrees into n cap, is equal to 1 into k cap. Since sine of 90 degrees is equal to 1 and n cap is equal to k cap, which is equal to k cap, this implies that I cap cross j cap is equal to k cap. Similarly, j cap cross k cap will be equal to I cap, and k cap cross I cap is equal to j cap. Therefore, we have I cap cross j cap is equal to k cap, j cap cross k cap is equal to I cap, and k cap cross I cap is equal to j cap. Also, as we know, vector A cross vector B is equal to minus of vector B cross vector A. So we have I cap cross j cap is equal to minus of j cap cross I cap. Here we have I cap cross j cap, which is equal to k cap, is equal to minus of j cap cross I cap. Also we have j cap cross k cap, which is equal to I cap, will be equal to minus of k cap cross j cap. And k cap cross I cap, which is equal to j cap, will be equal to minus of I cap cross k cap. Therefore we have I cap into j cap is equal to k cap, j cap into k cap is equal to I cap, k cap into I cap is equal to j cap, and similarly I cap into k cap is equal to minus of j cap, k cap into j cap is equal to minus of I cap, j cap into I cap is equal to minus of k cap. Now we shall learn how vector product can be expressed as a determinant. Let vector A be equal to A1 I cap plus A2 J cap plus A3 K cap. Vector B be equal to B1 I cap plus B2 J cap plus B3 K cap. Now vector A cross vector B is equal to A1 I cap plus A2 J cap plus A3 K cap cross B1 I cap plus B2 J cap plus B3 K cap, which is equal to A1 B1 into I cap cross I cap plus A1 B2 into I cap cross J cap plus A1 B3 into I cap cross K cap plus A2 B1 into J cap cross I cap plus A2 B2 into J cap cross J cap plus A2 B3 into J cap cross J cap plus A3 B1 into J cap cross I cap plus A3 B2 into J cap cross J cap plus A3 B3 into k cap cross k cap. And from our previous results we know that I cap cross j cap is equal to k cap, j cap cross k cap is equal to I cap, and k cap cross I cap is equal to j cap. Also we have I cap cross j cap, which is equal to k cap, is also equal to minus of j cap cross I cap. J cap cross K cap is equal to I cap and is also equal to minus of K cap cross J cap. K cap cross I cap, which is equal to J cap, is also equal to minus of I cap cross K cap. And from the second result we know that vector A cross vector A is equal to 0 vector. Using the above two results we get A2 into B3 minus of A3 into B2 into I cap plus A3 into B1 minus of A1 into B3 into J cap plus A1 into B2 minus of A2 into B1 into K cap, which can be written in the determinant form as vector A cross vector B is equal to the determinant containing elements I cap, J cap, K cap, A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3. Next is angle between two non-zero, non-parallel vectors. We have vector A cross vector B, which is equal to modulus of vector A into modulus of vector B into sine of angle theta into n cap, or we can write modulus of vector A cross vector B is equal to modulus of vector A into modulus of vector B into sine of angle theta into n cap, which can be written as modulus of vector A into modulus of vector B into sine of angle theta into modulus of unit vector n cap, which again can be written as modulus of vector A into modulus of vector B into sine of angle theta into 1, since modulus of unit vector n cap is equal to 1, which is equal to modulus of vector A into modulus of vector B into sine of angle theta. So we have modulus of vector A cross vector B is equal to modulus of vector A into modulus of vector B into sine of angle theta, which implies that sine of angle theta is equal to modulus of vector A cross vector B upon modulus of vector A into modulus of vector B. Next, we are going to discuss unit vector perpendicular to two given vectors. Let n cap be a unit vector perpendicular to two non-zero and non-parallel vectors. B, since vector A and vector B are non-zero and non-parallel, the cross product vector A cross vector B is non-zero. Now, we know that vector A cross vector B is equal to modulus of vector A into modulus of vector B into sine of angle theta into n cap, or we can write it as modulus of vector A cross vector B is equal to modulus of vector A into modulus of vector B into modulus of sine of angle theta into modulus of n cap. Since theta lies in between 0 and pi, therefore the value of sine of theta will always be greater than 0, and n cap is the unit vector and modulus of unit vector n cap will be equal to 1. Therefore, we get modulus of vector A cross vector B is equal to modulus of vector A into modulus of vector b into sine of angle theta into 1. Vector A cross vector B is equal to modulus of vector A into modulus of vector B into sine of angle theta into n cap. We mark this equation as 1. And equation 1 implies that vector A cross vector B is equal to modulus of vector A into modulus of vector B into sine of angle theta, which is equal to modulus of vector A cross vector B into n cap, which implies that unit vector n cap is equal to vector A cross vector B upon modulus of vector A cross vector B. Since the vector minus of vector A cross vector B is also perpendicular to the plane of vector A and vector B, therefore minus of vector A cross vector B upon modulus of vector A cross vector B is also a unit vector perpendicular to the plane of vector A and vector B. Therefore, unit vectors perpendicular to the plane of vector A and vector B are plus minus of vector A cross vector B upon modulus of vector A cross vector B. We should also note that unit vectors of length lambda, where lambda is not equal to 0, normal to the plane of vector A and vector B, are given by plus minus of lambda into vector A cross vector B upon modulus of vector A cross vector B, which is equal to plus minus of lambda upon modulus of vector A cross vector B into vector A cross vector B. This completes our session. Hope you enjoyed this session.